Hello, Fáilte. This is Laura O'Brien from the Irish Pagan School, and I'm here to answer one of our most commonly asked questions, which is, do I need to be born in Ireland to study with the Irish Pagan School? Do I need to have Irish ancestry? Do I need to be Irish? Is it cultural appropriation? And all of those are very valid questions, and we do appreciate the respect that people are showing. But we also hear the fear and we hear the insecurity. So I really wanted to be very, very clear here. You do not have to be born in Ireland to study Irish paganism, certainly not to study with us at the Irish Pagan School. Now, before we go any further, I will give you a gift, which is a free resource. So if you follow the link below or go to irishpagan.school/checklist, you will be able to see the free resources guide, this printable checklist guide that will give you a fantastic head start, because there's a lot of overwhelm about studying Irish paganism, Celtic paganism, about resources, about what's a good resource, what's a bad resource. In fact, that would probably be our second most commonly asked question. But back to our first most commonly asked question, which is, do I have to be born in Ireland to study Irish paganism or to study at the Irish Pagan School? And no, you don't. And while we do appreciate and we get a lot of people who pretty much info dump or download their, you know, very proud Irish ancestry and their DNA and all their connections, and my family was from here and my family was from there, Irish people don't really want to hear about that, just to be very clear, right? And really what it comes down to is we don't actually care, you know. We do understand that it's very important to you, and I know that there's a lot of people signing off now like, ooh, arrogant Irish. No, it's just that A, we hear about it a fucking lot, like a lot, from every single person who comes here, right? Which is probably about 8 or 9 million tourists every year. So if you're talking to an Irish people, they have fucking heard about Irish ancestry and connections, and my family left from Cork and we were from this and that. And we're very happy for you. We really are. And we love that you are here, that you are wherever you are in the world celebrating your Irish ancestry, your Irish DNA. But it is not necessary either to, you know, blow that all over your tourism contacts if you come to visit, but also it is not necessary to have Irish DNA. It is not some purity badge, because, you know, that way lies a lot of fucking racism and exceptionalism and all the rest of it. So there is no pure Irish heritage. There is no pure Irish blood. We're all mongrels here. And it's very, very important that people understand that you do not need that to follow an Irish spiritual path, to engage with Irish paganism. And when we teach our ancestry class, so your Irish ancestry is one of the classes that we teach at the Irish Pagan School, and it's a very popular class. But one of the things we talk about in the class is kind of the three legs of the stool. So it's not that your connection, your blood connection or your family connection to Ireland is completely irrelevant. Don't mishear me now, don't get me wrong. It's not that it's completely irrelevant. It's that it's not the most important thing. Your spiritual connection is and should be about relationships and the relationships that you build here and now. So of those kind of that three-legged stool or those three strands of ancestral connection, one of them is Irish ancestry and, you know, bloodlines and DNA and all the rest of it. And just as an aside, if anybody has told you that that they can trace your lineage back to some, you know, medieval high king, that is the biggest load of bullshit. So please don't fall for it. Please don't believe it. I know it's very tempting. I know it's very flattering, but it's simply inaccurate. We can't. There's no way, right? We don't have the records for that. Anyway, your Irish ancestry on the Irish Pagan School will teach you all about that, right? But what is important, as I said, is your relationship. And that is a two-way street. So while you don't have to be Irish to study Irish paganism or to study with us at the Irish Pagan School, you don't have to be born in Ireland. And for me personally, and kind of the definition that we go to with regard to being Irish, is very much about being engaged with the culture, either being born here or living here. I know that a lot of people with Irish ancestry have been told their whole lives that they are Irish. That is a form of colonial entitlement, and that particularly is a form of cultural appropriation. You have Irish descendancy, you have Irish ancestry, you are not Irish if you have not lived here in Ireland, engaged with the culture. And you know, you don't have to have been born here to be Irish either, just to be very, very clear. But living here and being part of the culture is very much what being Irish is about. Okay, so losing followers all over the place, here I am. But those of you who are willing to examine your own entitlement and examine the stuff that you have been fed, probably your whole lives, will appreciate it, and do appreciate it, because that's the feedback we get from our students, that, you know, some people have never heard this kind of stuff before. Some people have never had these boundaries put in place. Irish culture and heritage has been stripped from us, and our Irish identity is a hard won thing and is very much involved with the land here and the culture. Our national identity is pretty much interchangeable with a cultural identity, and you know, that's actually what I'm studying for my master's, so I'm neck deep in all of that research at the moment, so it's very near and dear to me currently. So the idea of being Irish is a complicated one, but ultimately it comes down to being immersed in the culture here, really. So that also puts a lot of the internal racism that we're getting at the moment to bed as well, just by the by, because yes, if somebody, you know, is a different skin color, has been born somewhere else and has moved here, is a refugee, if they're here for a while and they want to call themselves Irish, I personally have no problem with that. And I think any right-thinking, sound Irish person would have no problem with that. And the only people that have problems with that are the fucking racists, right? So, why do we do what we do at the Irish Pagan School? If we have so, you know, so many clear boundaries about what's Irish and what's not, and whether your heritage is important or whether it's not, one of the reasons that we do what we do is so that people all over the world who we recognize as kin, absolutely, this is our thua, this is our community. And Irish people have traveled all over the world. We have gone out and we have built a lot of the world, and we have settled. And a lot of the times people left Ireland and sent money home. So those of us who are here in Ireland owe a debt, in a lot of ways, to your ancestors who quite possibly sent money home and kept those of us who had the privilege of staying here alive. You know, we've had some hard times on this island, so that is definitely a thing that happened. So it's not that we're being arrogant, it's not that we're being anything, it's not that we're disparaging the diaspora. And again, the Irish Pagan School, we have, at time of recording, over 39,000 students enrolled here, and a good chunk of those are not Irish. I would say we used to have about 10% Irish people enrolled, but it's gone up over COVID. We're probably almost at about 20% Irish students, as in students based in Ireland currently. So that's great. Irish people were re-examining a lot of their stuff over the last couple of years for various reasons, and have come to it maybe a new appreciation of what's here. So we're definitely seeing the results of that with our Irish enrollments at the Irish Pagan School. But that leaves 80% of people who are worldwide. So clearly we do what we do to facilitate those people having an authentic connection to Ireland. And that's a very important part. That's literally our mission statement, is authentic connection to Ireland. So wherever you are in the world, wherever you were born in the world, that is what we want to give to you. That is what we want to provide for you, is authentic connection to Ireland. And in that vein, we have, as I mentioned earlier, a free gift, which is a resources guide. So please do go down below and start to figure out what resources are quality and what are not, because a lot of what you've been fed is bullshit, as I have said already. And unfortunately, there's a lot of crap out there about Celtic paganism, about Irish paganism. So that PDF guide is divided up into 10 different relevant topics. And there are free and paid resources on a nice handy little checklist that you can work your way through. Okay, mostly free, in fairness. Most of the resources on there are free, and the guide is free. So, irishpagan.school/checklist. And if you're here with me on YouTube, there'll be a link below. Okay, slán go fóill, and I will see you in the next video.